This Ask Dr. Durie is one of the frequently asked questions with regard to the COVID-19 infection. This is frequently asked question number 4. And many patients have very specific questions about possible changes in their medications right now that might improve safety or be helpful. One of them relates to the use of dexamethasone, which is a steroid and a medicine which can mask the onset of fever. It can also increase the risks associated with infection. And so there is a broad recommendation, which is to discuss dexamethasone with your doctor and see if possibly the dosage can be reduced, or maybe dexamethasone could be stopped for a couple of months to reduce that kind of a risk. With regard to other medications, in general, it seems that the medications that you take are not a particular risk related to the COVID-19 infection. However, they can become a risk if the dosages are too high and are producing low blood counts. So something to discuss carefully with your doctor is if your blood counts, particularly your white blood cell count, is dropping low with your medicines each month, consider reducing the dose or the schedule. For example, with Revlimid, one simple thing to do during this period of time is to take the Revlimid for 2 weeks instead of 3 weeks, just reducing the risk of low blood counts and giving you some extra recovery time. And so you can see that there are a number of these simple adjustments that can be made. Another type of adjustment is to consider using a by-mouth version of a drug versus an intravenous or a shot approach. And so, for example, proteasome inhibitors are Velcade, Kyprolis, and Ninlaro, which is by mouth. These are all proteasome inhibitors. At this point in time, it could be a safe option to consider the Ninlaro, which is an oral proteasome inhibitor, and substitute this for a couple of months or so, and this will reduce the number of visits to the office, the need for blood count checks and the like. And so this can be a helpful switch at this moment in time. The bottom line with regard to the adjustments is please follow up with your doctor, use telemedicine, telephone, or email, and set plans so that both you and your doctor are happy with the planning, which will allow you to keep your myeloma under control, but protect you from the risks of low blood counts, and protect you from the risks of having to go in too frequently to the clinic, and certainly to avoid going into the hospital if at all possible.